Hello everyone. Today we will talk about the architecture solution called microservices. Let's begin. As our application begins to develop, we have problems such as how we need to allocate places and how to manage the team that we use in other projects. Maybe it's time to divide the project into microservices. Microservices are components of the application usually divided by functionalities that operate independently of each other. It allows to easily maintain and create a project that consists of various technologies, for example, databases and programming languages. Information exchange between microservices should be according to specific standards in order to maintain independence. Communication between services is usually done by using REST API or by using the Redis queue. Microservices management is a set of techniques and practices for managing the life cycle of microservices implementations. It is also related to the monitoring and control of individual microservices. This problem is most evident when microservices are located on different servers. We must remember to monitor the occupancy and consumption of the server, check logs from various applications, so that our continuous integration process takes into account the implementation of changes to the appropriate servers. Microservices are beneficial because they allow a service to scale independently of other services. For example, if you have an image processing microservice and another one for social media data analysis, the two services can be scaled separately. This is not possible for monolithic architectures, where scaling one component may affect others on the system as well. Microservice architecture is a software system design that structures an application as a set of loosely coupled services. This means that the benefits of this approach include increased scalability, reduced need for manual integration, and ability to independently develop and deploy features. It is worth paying attention especially to the possibility of scaling. Rarely is that every module in the database is equally important and needs scaling just as quickly. Thanks to the division into microservices, we can focus on modifications such as the introduction of a load balancer, thanks to which it will be possible to scale only the necessary modules on the servers that require it due to security requirements or increasing data volume. Load balancer manages traffic between different servers in order to optimize their load. It is especially important when the database grows to sizes requiring several servers. The main problem is the lack of a single point of control. This means that there are many different teams managing different services, and it becomes difficult to coordinate changes. My point is, there are a lot of different microservice management teams, which makes it difficult for them to change anything. The problem with microservices is that developing microservices is problematic. This is because when there are many microservices, performance increases linearly, but complexity increases exponentially. Another problem with microservice architecture is that it can be difficult to debug or troubleshoot a distributed system. The third major problem with this type of architecture is that each service needs its own database, which can lead to high costs and vendor lockdown for businesses. It is not always clear when to use microservice architecture. Microservices can be a good fit for your application if the following criteria are met. Your application has many different components or services that can be broken down into smaller, more manageable parts. You need to scale each component independently of other components to meet the demand. You want to release new features and bug fixes without having to update all parts of the system at once. When we need to use some needs out of necessity, for example, when we want to use clever intelligence from Python, and we have a project in PHP. If we have a team specializing in various technologies, and we do not want to risk recruiting new employees, because we do not know what the demand will be. We recommend you stick to the end and watch all our videos in the playlist. Check sources of this video in the description, where you can find more information. Leave the like, comment and subscribe, and share it with friends that want to improve programming skills. Not recommended, however, sometimes communication via the database and issued commands are also used. We can also store code for different microservices on one repository and have all microservices running on one server. This obviously strikes the independence of each of these services, but it is worth considering such simplifications if the implementation and monitoring of microservices are too costly for us in its full form. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.